Hello students, this is Amardeep Singh, your IT teacher. So today we will discuss about session 6 of unit 2, working with page breaks and section breaks. Page breaks are basically used to separate contents of a Word document into different pages, and the section breaks are used to split a document into different sections or paragraphs. So if you want to use page break or section break, then you have to click on page layout tab, this section. Then we are having breaks option. When you will click on breaks, then it will explore page break and section breaks. So first we will discuss about page breaks and its types. We are having three types of page breaks: page, column and text wrapping. So first we will discuss about page break. This option makes the word processor introduce a page break so that the contents are shifted to the next page. So what you have to do, you have to place your cursor or your insertion point anywhere inside the text. Then you have to go break section, then click on this section, page. Then see what happened. The text after that insertion point is moved to the next page. So that's all about page option inside page break. Next we are having column break inside break section. So if you want to use this column option, then you have to create multiple columns in your documents. So first of all, we'll discuss what is a column break. This type of a break causes the following text to begin at the top of the next column. So to use this option, we have to convert the text into two columns. So first of all, you have to select the text. Then inside page layout tab, we are having columns option. You can click on this one. We are having option 2 column, 3 columns. So we'll use 2 column. So now you can see the text is converted to 2 columns. Then to use column break, what you have to use, you have to place your cursor, your insertion point anywhere inside the column. So I'll place my cursor here in before this text. So what we have to do, we have to click on breaks, then columns. Now you can see that the text after that insertion point moves to the next column. So it's all about column breaks. Next we are having text wrapping break inside the break section. So text wrapping break is also known as line break, or with the help of this option we can wrap or move the text to the next line. So we have to click or place the insertion point anywhere inside the paragraph. Let's suppose we place the cursor here, and then we'll move to break section. And when you will click on text wrapping break, you can see the text after that insertion point is moved to the next line. That's all. So after discussing page breaks, we will discuss about section breaks in this section. So section breaks are basically used to create a new section or a paragraph on the same page or on the next page. So we are having 4 types of section breaks: next page, continuous, even page, odd page. So we'll discuss about next page first. So this type of section break is used to start a new section on the next page. That means it will start a new section. So what you have to do, you have to place the cursor anywhere inside the text, then go to break section, then click on next page. So now you can see it moves the text after the insertion point to the next page and create a new section, or you can say it creates a new paragraph on the next page. Next we will discuss about continuous section break. A continuous section break is used, this break, it is used to make a new section on the same page instead of creating a new page. So you have to place your insertion point or your cursor inside the paragraph or inside the text written. Then click on break and click continues. So now you can see it creates a new section, or you can say a new paragraph, on the same page. Next we are having even and odd section breaks, these two breaks. So even section break is used to start a new section on the next even numbered page, like 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. And odd page break is used to start a new section on the next odd numbered page, like 3, 5, 7, etc. So presently we are on page number 1. We will place a cursor here, and if we'll click on even page, even section break, then it will move the text to it will create a new section on the next even numbered page, that is page number 2. So click on this option. Now you can check, it creates a new section on page number 2. And in case we click on odd section break, then it will create a new section on next odd numbered page. That means presently we are on page number 1. If we'll click on this option, this odd section break option, then it will move and create a new section on next odd numbered page, that is page number 3. Now click on this one. Now you can check, after page number 1, it will create, it creates a new section on page number 3. That's all about even and odd section breaks. Next, if you want to check how many page or section breaks that we have placed in the present document, then we have to click on Home tab, and then here we are having an option known as Show and Hide Page Breaks or Session Breaks. If you will click on this one, it will show all the page breaks and section breaks on your document. So presently we are not having any page or section breaks. So first of all, again, it's a toggle button basically. So if you will click, it will hide all the options. So what you have to do, first of all, we have to insert some breaks here. So let's suppose I click here and page layout, then break. We'll insert our text wrapping break. That means it will move the text to the next line. And on another section here, we'll use another break, like a continuous section break. So on this document, we are having two breaks. One is text wrapping space and second one continuous section break. So if you will move to Home tab and click on this option, this button which is used to show or hide page break or section break section, then you can see, click on this option. Now you can see that we are having two breaks on this page. Here we place, this symbol is used to indicate that we have placed our text wrapping space break, and this section indicates that we have placed a section break. After showing all type of breaks, you can also use the same option to delete any kind of break from your document. So if you want to delete any kind of break, then what you have to do, you have to click on this section, like we want to remove this section break, then you have to click here and from the keyboard press delete button. Now you can see it removes the section break. If you want to remove this text wrapping space a break, then you have to click here, then again press delete button. Now you can see it remove all the all type of breaks that you have inserted in the current document. So that's all about deleting section and page breaks. So that's all about page and section breaks and how to manage all type of breaks. So if you are having any kind of query, then you can contact me anytime. Thank you very much.